नमस्कार प्रणय मिर्जाच्या हॅलो दत्त ह्या कार्यावळीन तुमकां सगळ्यांक मना काळजाचो नेवकार. आयज आमच्या कार्यावळीन आमचे बरोबर आसा डॉक्टर नागराजा सामगांव, गोंयचे नामनेचे आयुर्वेदीक प्रॅक्टिशनर. आयचो विशय सगळ्यांच्या आवडीचो आसा, पूण त्याचप्रमाणे म्हाका एक अफ्लुएंट क्लास जी आमच्या मदीं खुबशे लोक शिकिल्ले आसतात आनी बरे शिकिल्ले सवरिल्ले आसतात अशें म्हणपाक हरकत ना, आनी तांकां जी वेगळ्या प्रकारची दुयेंसां जातात, स्पेशली लायफस्टायल डिजॉर्डर्स जी आमी म्हणटा, ताचे विशीं विस्कटान म्हायती दिवपा खातीर आज डॉक्टर नागराजा आमच्या बरोबर आसात. डॉक्टर वेलकम टू द स्टुडियो. बेसिकली आयचो जे प्रश्न उत्तरां आसा ती थोडीशी इंग्लिशीन आसतली, पण मदीं मदीं हांव कोंकणीन तुमकां ट्रान्सलेट करून अणकारीत करून सांगपाचो प्रयत्न करतलो. पण हांवें जशें सुरवातीकच सांगलां, आयचो विशय जो धरला तो आमी एक अफ्लुएंट क्लास हांचे खातीर धरला, ह्याच खातीर की जेन्ना आमी उलयतात एक मेटाबॉलीक डिजॉर्डर्स किंवा ज्यो आतां ह्यो सगळ्यो नव्यो जी दुयेंसां आसात तांचो बरोचसो सहवास किंवा समभाग आमच्या दिसपट्ट्या जिणेचेर आसता, आमचो डायट, आमचो आहार, आमची दिसपट्टी जिणेत. सो लायफस्टायल मॅनेजमेंट इज अ व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट ऑर की वर्ड इन ऑल दीस आय फील, इन्क्लुडींग कॅन्सर. सो डॉक्टर, वेन वी टॉक अबाउट लायफस्टायल मॅनेजमेंट डिजॉर्डर्स, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल लेट्स कम टू सम बाउंड्रीज. विच लायफस्टायल डिजॉर्डर्स यू सी कॉमनली इन युअर प्रॅक्टीस?
मोस्ट ऑफन इट इज ओबेसिटी, डायबिटीस, हायपर टेन्शन, हायपर कोलेस्ट्रॉलेमिया.
So these are the major things which we see
every day few cases I see.
Correct. म्हणजे दोतर म्हणटा की डायबिटीस असता, प्रेशराचे असता, ओबेसिटी म्हणजे लठ्ठपणा हे असा. सो ऑल दीस कम्स अंडर दीस लायफस्टायल मॅनेजमेंट असे जनरली असे धरतात आणि हे आयुर्वेदिक मेडिसिन डॉक्टर सुद्धा असेच गृहित धरतात. सो डॉक्टर, व्हॉट आर द मेन कॉजेस ऑफ दीस? सी, वेन वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट लायफस्टायल मॅनेजमेंट डिसऑर्डर्स ऑर वेन वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट दीस स्पेशली यंग एज, सी टुडेज प्रोग्राम आय एम फोकसिंग ओनली ऑन द यंग एज, young, budding, dynamic, dashing, enthusiastic age group. So where they are little liberal in their work, they are stressed up because now we don't understand, but they have got tremendous stress. Those who have not got job, they are under stress. Those who have got job, they are under stress. Those who have got promotion, they are under stress. Those who are yet to get promotion, they are under stress. Those who are married are under stress, and those who are unmarried are also under stress. So with this statement, doctor, what you feel about this diabetes, means management of all these disorders, or what are the causes? Let's come to the causes first.
This is the age group I'm exactly focusing on, because this is the time where we can correct their metabolic activity.
Absolutely.
Once you spoil, once you cross 50, there are so many complications coming, so we have to focus on the disease.
Yeah.
Now at the age like 20 to 40, this is the age.
Absolutely.
Where we can correct their metabolism, correct their activities, correct their food, and correct their sleep.
Yeah.
And get them back on track of health.
Correct.
So Ayurveda focuses on the protecting the health of a healthy person. Swasthasya swasthya rakshanam. That's the first purpose.
Mm.
Then the second purpose is aturasya vikara prashamanam cha. So then treat the diseased.
Mm.
First, why not protect the health when you are healthy?
Mm.
Why not protect the health?
Mm.
How can you protect the health of a person? They're following the rules of Ayurveda.
Mm.
Ayurveda says, who is a healthy person?
Mm.
Samadosha samagnishcha samadhatu malakriya prasanna atma indriya manaha swastha ityabhidiyate. So the dosha functions, yeah, the body's dosha functions are to be, should be proper. Yeah, dhatus, there are seven dhatus body is made up of. The functions of dhatus should be working properly. And sama agni, yeah, metabolic fire should be proper. When the metabolic fire is proper, your tissue formation will be good and tissue will be healthy. And malakriyaha, so defecation or the urine excretion or sweating, these three are three main malas, should get cleared. Once they are having properly going on,
yeah.
And prasanna atma indriya manaha, not only is physical health, prasanna atma, your soul should be happy, your indriya, sensory organs should be happy, manaha should be happy. When these three are happy and contented, then only you are called as swastha, healthy person.
So what we usually say in allopathic life, we say like physical, mental and social well-being. And now we also add spiritual
absolutely,
well-being.
Absolutely.
So it is not just absence of disease, but well-being of physical, mental, social and spiritual well-being. Correct?
Yeah.
So you also have almost a similar track, and so I'm happy so that we both can work together for a better society.
Absolutely.
So now
yes.
You can answer for the thing.
So to remain healthy, so Ayurveda has clearly mentioned three pillars what you have to follow. The three pillars of health. I want to show, give a small demo. Now I'm just holding this.
Yeah.
Okay. Now it is balanced with three pillars. Even one pillar also I move, it collapses. So these three pillars are Ahara, Nidra, Brahmacharyam. Trayupasambaha iti. Three pillars of health. First is food. Second is sleep. Third is Brahmacharyam, activities. So right food, consumed at a right time. Right sleep, taken at a right time. And right activities. At a right time will keep you healthy. Now the health is stable.
Achcha.
If you consider this as health, health is stable.
So basically this is like a tripod stand where tripod you have three camera, and then if it is imbalanced, then the
it's
your picture will also
collapse.
Get distorted and camera also get distorted.
True.
Correct?
True. Now the, if the food, now you cannot say what, which is the best food. Many patients come and ask, sir, what is the best food for me? Best food to eat.
Correct.
They say this is good, this is available, best in the market, we have multi-grain atta, should I have? It has everything, nutrients. That is not the right way to have food. Best food is considered as good one when it is when your body handles it well.
Achcha.
So it, my food and your food may differ.
Oh.
What is good for my constitution
may not be good for me.
May not be good for you.
Correct.
So you have to see what is traditionally cooked in your family is the best food for you. Traditionally cooked. What your grandmother cooked, what your mother cooked, okay? What you are eating at home. Not the tasty food what is available in the market. The tasty food is made tasty that you eat more and get into diseases.
Correct.
So that automatically you go to hospitals and you spend more money. You earn money to live a happy life and ultimately you spend all the money to die poor.
Good life.
Okay. So the right food for you keeps nourishes your body. All the seven tissues are nourished properly. Then sleep. Sleep. 7 to 8 hours sleep is compulsorily needed and it has to be in the night. So according to Ayurveda, day sleep is not allowed. Sleep in the night is compulsory. Ratri Jagarana not allowed and Divasvapna not allowed. Okay, now in certain conditions like deceased or children or pregnant lady, postnatal, they are allowed to sleep in the daytime, but there is a certain hours are given, the compensatory sleep is called. Okay, if you did not sleep in the night, you can sleep half time of the sleep in the daytime. If you could not sleep 5 hours in the night, you can sleep 2.5 hours in the morning before taking breakfast. That is allowed. Okay.
Oh.
That is allowed. But if you sleep in the daytime, automatically your channels start getting clogged. And once the body micro channels getting clogged, then you are heading to into a disease. So always see that you don't sleep much in the daytime. You can take a small nap or power nap. Okay, or sitting position only can nap, but don't get into a deep sleep. Third, activities. When it comes to activities, it is mental activity and physical activity. Mental activity by meditation, prayers. You should learn how to surrender before God.
Correct.
Because we are not the boss.
Correct.
Okay, there is someone who is taking care of every one of us.
Absolutely.
He is giving us food, he is giving us light, he is taking care of us. Surrender to him. Then your ego suppression helps us a lot in enjoying life. Physical activity by workout, gym, swim, walk, jog, whatever is good for you. Never copy the other person.
Correct.
He is doing jogging, it may not suit you.
Absolutely.
But after the age of 45, 50, you are not supposed to jog. You are going to damage your joint, then you will not be able to walk even.
Correct.
Just see your limits. Do everything in your limits. Once you understand your limits and go on working out the physically and mentally, you live a happy and healthy life.
So basically, Dr. Rajshri said that, see, Dr. Teen Goshti Mahatwaji Sangla, ki ek manche, amchi yogya need, ek sa te saat wara, ratchi need gyo Mahatwaji asa, disa che nipak jayana, amchi Ayurvedic sangta, ni Dr. Rita sangta, amchi Ayurveda sangta, tes te Dr. Paradam ka sangla, ki jo manchar tumche ratchi need pura hai, complete jayana, to manchar tumka disa che nipak jayana, आणि दिसाचे निदले आणि जर रातचे सारखे निदून जर तुमका वेगळे दुयेंसा जाऊ शकतात. दुसरे जाणे की योग्य आहार की जे आम्ही खाता ते म्हणजे ट्रॅडिशनल म्हणजे आमच्या परंपरेप्रमाणे जे आम्ही शिजत आयला ते आमचा आहार असता की त्या त्या ट्रेंड आता लाईक गोयचा आहार वेगळा असू शकता, केरळचा वेगळा असू शकता, महाराष्ट्रातला वेगळा असू शकता, ते परंपरागत जो आहार असा तो घेऊपाचं महत्त्वाचं असं. तिसरे सांगणं जे ॲक्टिव्हिटी म्हणजे आमकां त्या दर फोडे सांगता की आम्ही असंच फक्त ऑपरेट झालं, आमकां स्कूटर जाय, आमकां चॅनल हे रिमोट जाय, हे सगळे रिमोटाचे धंदे बंद करून चलपाचे किंवा धावपाचे, ते असं तुमच्या शारीरिक योग्यते प्रमाणे. बेस्ट 50 वर्षा मनशाक धावपाक लावप इज योग्य न्हय, तसे 40 वर्षाचा मनीस सुशाकात चलता असे नाही, बिकॉज ही कॅन रन. सो दॅट्स वॉट वॉट इज रिक्वायर्ड यू कॅन डू. डॉक्टर, आय गॉट अ व्हेरी डिबेटेबल क्वेश्चन
अँड
दॅट इज व्हेरी डिबेटेबल क्वेश्चन. सी मीन्स इट्स अ ट्रिकी क्वेश्चन ऑर यू कॅन टेक इज अकॅडमिक ट्विस्ट विच आय ऑलवेज लाईक टू प्ले.
ओके.
सी आयुर्वेद ऑलवेज मीन्स एज पर माय इन्फॉर्मेशन रिकमेंड्स आयुर्वेद आय मीन व्हेजिटेरियन डायट. बट द बट इज हियर. सी वी आर ऑल द coastal people, like you also came from, must be from Kerala,
yeah,
and we are from Goa. So our fish is one of our staple diet. It's okay. A staple food which we cannot take away. So rice and fish in whatever form, whether fried or curry or whatever you feel, but this has become our staple diet. Often sometimes whenever you go to Ayurvedic doctor first, no, you should take that. The moment he says veg diet, the patient decides, okay, I will change the doctor. I change. So that's I'm not saying you make a very harsh statement saying that, oh, chalega. But I want you to come to some balancing statement so that we can, as you rightly said, because since you have made this statement, okay, as per the tradition, but also I agree that our people who are taking this fish curry rice also were working hard, and now we are not working at all. Practically 10% work, just mind is working and physically we are resting. And I always say that mind should be resting 10%, this thing, and body should be working 90%, which doesn't happen. So taking on this, all this account, I want you to make a balancing statement which will make our audience also happy and me also happy.
So it's a very wrong this thing. Like Ayurveda is never against non-veg food. When Ayurveda has given a detailed description of all the meats and their qualities, all the meat and their qualities.
Yeah.
Okay. So now what suits you is the best food for you.
Acha, okay.
It's not you cannot say this is the best food.
Correct.
I said. Yeah. Now fish suits many people.
Yeah.
Especially since your childhood you are having fish. Absolutely. Your body knows how to handle it.
Yes.
Okay, when time comes when your body cannot handle, then you start showing some symptoms of disease.
Correct.
That is the time you have to
Switch over.
Correct. Or minimize.
Yes.
So many patients come with, for example, uric acid. Now we stop them using shellfishes.
Correct.
Okay. Or red meat.
Yeah.
Red fishes.
Yeah.
Okay. Now he will say, since childhood I'm eating this, why should I stop.
Correct.
It?
Yeah.
Okay. Have it. Then you're the one who's suffering.
Correct.
If you don't want to suffer,
yeah,
change. It's because of your activity, you're suffering.
Yeah.
If you don't want to suffer, you should be ready to change.
Correct.
Okay. Absolutely. We allow you. Okay, now have white fish. White perforate. Silver fish.
Yeah.
Okay. Maybe safer.
Yeah.
Compared to
so
this.
You are giving options.
As per the disease condition.
As per disease condition. And if suppose the things are going out of control, that will happen even whether you are allopathic or you are Ayurvedic. Even in allopathy, we will also recommend the same thing. It is not that only Ayurvedic recommend it. But if the time is really cut off point, then you will have to do something.
Exactly.
Otherwise, for a normal, healthy person, a Goan person, doctor has recommended, okay, what recommended, doctor has given a signal, okay, chalo, it can be chalega. But always eating non-veg is also become monotonous.
Absolutely.
So
yes.
Sometimes you should be taking a little veg also for a change. Fortunately, most of the Hindu people, they take Monday and veg or Thursday as veg day.
Yes.
So I think that is a good practice. Whether you believe in God or you don't believe in God, that may be secondary, but at least traditional practice to hai. Ghar mein koi banata nahi. So doctor, one more thing I just want. Now we are talking, taking you another very crucial point. Since we are talking about lifestyle disorders management.
Before that, I want to add one.
Yes, sure, add one point. Yeah.
So when we talk about vegetarian food, Ayurveda has never propagated vegetarian food. Okay. But we always say vegetarian is needed. Because people say vegetarian is healthy. Why healthy? So what is the meaning of vegetarian diet? There's a vegetarian is a Latin word. There's a simple concept. You can give what you have. You can't give what you don't have.
Correct.
Simple.
Yeah.
Now vegetarian is a Latin word which means life giving.
Yeah.
Okay.
Achha.
So plants have life.
Oh.
They're living.
Yeah.
They can give life to your body. Chicken is dead. Okay. Now, don't take me wrong. It's not against non-veg. Add life to your non-veg food. You are allowed to eat chicken, but have some veg food along with.
Correct.
Because chicken is good in protein, good in so many things.
Yeah.
I agree.
Yeah.
But then the health should come from the life.
Correct.
That is green.
Absolutely.
Add green to your non-veg food.
Yeah. In fact, my
tell every patient of mine to have some veg.
Correct.
Whenever you have non-veg, not only Monday and
Thursday. So you should balance. So yes. A Goan person is allowed to eat fish, but with balance.
Absolutely. Exactly. Added vegetables.
Correct. This yeah. I will take as a final seal from you. Okay, doctor. Now I have got very important question.
Yes.
Because whenever we are talking about lifestyle disorder, whether we are talking allopathy, Ayurveda, whatever it is. See, Ayurveda has its own concepts because you have got types of personalities like Vat, Pit, Kapha, correct?
Yes.
So, and these three dosh, if I'm not mistaken.
Three dosh.
So, in those three dosh, you are categorizing people. Like, see, how we categorize on blood group, whether A, B, or AB, or whatever. What is. So, this categorization is always there, whether you are in, but only how you look at it. So, one thing. Second thing, what I'm asking you, very important question. Often, even elite group, educated people, highly educated people, and affluent group, whenever person specially, I'm talking about, because now I say over, it's a randomized practice, over the counter sale of medicine, so called as anti-diabetic or against diabetes, they are just sold like in and out, like anything. What happens? I want to know. Because see, a person, like say any person just going to pharmacist, buying medicine like Karela ka juice or Amla juice or that Jamun ka juice, he feels that this is a medicine, and see, he takes under the pretext, uspe stamp hai ki Ayurvedic medicines are safe. Wo stamp hai ya nahi, that I don't, but he feels Ayurvedic medicine is safe. So he doesn't bother what is the dosage, he doesn't bother how many times to take, he doesn't bother whether it fits me or it doesn't suit me. So I want your perfect statement on this, because this is the program today we are making especially for the youngsters, and I want everybody to watch this program and take home their important message from you. Okay.
So when it comes to youngster, rather than depending more on the medicine, they should focus on these three pillars.
Absolutely.
Unless until they correct these three pillars of health, they are not going to come out of any of the disease. Hmm. The physical activity, mental activity, right food and right sleep, they have to follow. Hmm. When they follow this, rarely they get into disease. Hmm. Now, if they have a certain disease, first they should come back to these three pillars. Hmm. Now, fourth one comes as a medicine. Hmm. Now, where is medicine here? For health, does not need medicine.
Correct.
Because this three is balanced. Hmm. Now, medicine comes as a fourth, like when you don't do anything right. Food is bad, medicine. Sleep is not bad, medicine. Hmm. And where do I have a tablet for exercise? Okay. You have to.
Yeah.
That exercise is the most important. Hmm. Then when these three are not helping you, then as a support, we give medicines. Hmm. That is a doctor who has to decide what is right for you. Hmm. It is not the medical store person. Hmm. For selling, he may sell anything.
Correct.
And the person who does not want to stand in the queue, does not want to take appointment, doesn't want to pay the fees to doctor.
Correct.
Then he ultimately buys something what the pharmacy person sells. Hmm. He sells what is profitable for, maybe.
Correct.
Profitable for
Absolutely.
Him. It may not suit him. For now, for example, you said jambu.
Yeah.
The jambul juice.
Yeah.
Now, if a person is of vata constitution, if he takes too much of jambul juice, he will suffer badly from constipation.
I see.
And he will get into major other diseases because of constipation. Mm. He will not understand why is he suffering from. Then he will keep giving a visit to hospitals to correct that. Then doctor will keep giving some medicines. He will not mention to the doctor that he is taking jambul juice.
Correct.
Because he doesn't want, he want to hide this from the doctor. Ultimately, who is suffering? The patient himself is suffering. Mm. Had he been like taken advice from the doctor that he has been taking these things, maybe doctor could advise him the right way, the right food and right activities and right medicine. It has to come from a doctor.
Basically,
because doctor can judge your constitution.
Correct.
Judge the seven tissues of the body functioning. Okay. Judge the defecation or the urine output. Okay. Then he can advise you.
So these medicines are not so, though we may feel they are safe, they may not cause death actually, but they may harm you in other ways. And sometimes, as you have rightly said, we may not understand why this happened. Like see, you said, like you are taking jambul ka juice, but you may have constipation, which you may not realize that is because of that. Sometimes, doctor, again, I'm telling you another thing. Sometimes, okay, I agree that sometimes with these medicines, the blood sugar level goes down or your HbA1c goes down and they feel they are okay, job is done. Like my glucose has gone down, my job is done. But what I recollect from your statement, there may be other things which they are harming.
True.
So which should not happen. So even if you keep this in mind, you should visit. Suppose I'm not saying that, doctor, now we are at such a high time that every fourth person in Goa is supposed to be diabetic or pre-diabetic. These are latest statistics of ICMR. And this is truth statistic. There is not just guesswork. So now there is a role of everybody, whether it is allopathic practitioner, Ayurvedic practitioner, not only doctor. I always say this is a role of the teacher, there is a role of the agriculturist, absolutely. There is a role of each and every individual. Yeah. So now unless all of us come together and join hands, we cannot fight this malice.
True.
So at this point of time, why we are telling again and again, it is just not going to pharmacy or over the counter or seeing some advertisement or TV pe advertisement aata hai, kahan board laga hai. That is not the way.
Absolutely.
If you feel that you want to go to Ayurvedic practitioner, I'll say, okay, you can go to Ayurvedic practitioner, you can go to homeopathy people, you can go to Unani or whatever you feel convenient, but follow the advice of the doctor.
Absolutely.
Trained doctor's advice is a must rather than just going to the pharmacy and buying the medicine. Second important message is this. Some people, they feel like, mera chacha ka theek ho gaya, my cousin's sugar has come normal with this. So now I'm also taking that. That is wrong. Correct, doctor?
Medicine never can be copied.
Yes.
Because for him, the reason for the disease may be different. And for you, the reason for disease may be different.
Hmm.
The cause of the disease has to be identified.
Correct.
Nidana parivarjana meva chikitsa. What has created the disease has to be corrected.
Correct.
The pathogenesis should be
clear.
Controlled. Yes, yeah. Clear. Then only he can live a healthy and happy life.
Barabha.
And how the prescription, many times, the prescription a patient takes and say, can I give it to my uncle also, who has the same cough? We got the same time we cough.
Yeah.
Maybe, say, it is a cough mixture.
Correct.
But why you suffer from cough, why he suffer from cough, may be different.
Correct.
Your constitution may be different, medicine may be different. In Ayurveda, disease may be one or the medicine will be different.
Correct.
As per the body constitution and the tissue health conditions.
So basically, again, important message for all of us that don't copy the medicine thinking that this is given to this gentleman or this has worked in my auntie or my cousin, so it will work with me. That is a wrong practice. Again, I repeat, the causes of your illness are different. So is the treatment.
Absolutely.
See, yes. It is like what you see if you want to cook chicken, you cannot use the same masala like the fish curry rice. So that fish curry ka masala alag hai, chicken ka masala alag hai, and if you buy some other fish or some other vegetable, masala is different. So that masala is different as per the composition, what you are cooking. So same way, your composition, the cause of illness, will decide what medicine will work for you, not the pharmacist or not the hoarding, correct?
Absolutely.
So doctor, these are very important. See, always, you know, why I'm telling you again and again, see doctor, what happened now, we are in a stage, you know, especially I'm always worried about diabetes. Tomorrow. People at, suppose that next generation will ask like, what you people did? So at least I can say, we tried hard to convince you people that what you followed or you didn't follow, that was left
it's
to you.
To them, yes.
Doctor, again, I'm repeating, especially about our new generation, not sleeping on time, keeping late awake. I don't know whether they're really busy on the office work or what type of work, but it's a wrong practice. So you should follow something which is good for your health. And good for your health, one of the most important ingredient is your sleep. Correct?
True.
See, exercise, I believe, I hope, and I recommend to you that please start walking. At least a simple basic exercise. We don't recommend you to go to gym and do some 100 kg weightlifting.
True.
So that is not recommended. Second thing, diet, whatever you feel convenient, what your traditional people have eaten. But again, I'm repeating this statement. Our all ancestors have taken good amount of fish, but they worked hard. That's why they could digest and they had a very healthy life.
Healthy life.
Doctor has given us green signal. He has not said, he said, okay, you no need of avoiding non-vegetarian food as such. But along with non-veg food, you should always have sufficient quantity of veg items, which will balance your food.
Yeah.
Absolutely, doctor.
Absolutely.
It is very good. So now we are going to another little, since we are managing about diabetes. Also, hypertension is also coming up because of this. Again, our wrong lifestyle, our stress, and all this factor. All of us, we have this. What you would like to talk on this? In short, you can just, because we have got another three, four minutes.
So, hypertension, in case of hypertension also, like the first, learn to handle the stress. Every person is stressed. For some reason, he says, okay, the targets in life.
Correct.
Every person sets a higher target, whether it is possible with him or not.
Correct.
He will not. Since the neighbor is doing it, I want
Absolutely.
To do it.
Correct.
Since the neighbor purchased a bigger car, I want to have a bigger car.
Absolutely.
He has gone for a foreign tour. Why not? Yeah. So in that bargain, he keep on harassing himself.
Correct.
To earn more. And when it is not possible, because it's very challenging.
Correct.
The business is very challenging. When he cannot do that, he comes under so much of stress.
Hmm.
And the demand at home front also puts him extra stress. When he cannot handle, the pressure rises. Wrong food, of course, is there. The wrong food practices or wrong sleep. Nowadays, the mobile keeps everyone occupied.
Yes, yes, yes.
The person who would happily sleep at 9, he will sleep at 12.
Absolutely.
Because 3 hours of him is eaten by the mobile.
Correct.
So whether it is needed or not, he is connected with the outer world. Whether it is needed or not, he is getting into a problem. And sedentary. Once he holds a mobile, he's in without moving, he can spend 3 hours.
Absolutely.
And is
focus on
creating
the
problem on the spine.
Correct.
And with the obesity, one side it's rising, and the degenerative problems in the spine is increasing, and the sugar burning is not happening, glucose burning not happening, and insulin resistance developing, and person is getting into diabetes, other complications, hypertension, heart conditions, one after the other.
So
one started, and the rest will follow.
So the full family of metabolic disorders start coming.
Then he's worried. Why I have disease? Why not the other? The always question. Because he eats the same thing. I eat the same thing. But he did something else what you did not do. That people will not understand.
Absolutely.
And one more important thing, it's the processed food, what is available in the market.
Yeah.
No. If you want to live healthy, eat a home-cooked food.
Yes. So again, this I take as an important message. Home-cooked food. Ghara, ranile, javan, all available juices. Taken at home, not from the packages, not stored food.
Absolutely.
All these things can give you a very healthy and happy life. Doctor has again and again recommended us taking enough amount, quality sleep, which I keep on hampering because our sleep is not adequate. At most of the time, people want to sleep during daytime. Some people neither have time to during sleep a day or daytime to sleep. And nighttime, they keep on, as the doctor has rightly said about on mobile and all this. So we must all stop this for a healthy life. Again, I say, whenever you have got any problem, especially diabetes, when we are talking about this metabolic disorders stands first, all of us, I recommend, you can go to any doctor of your choice, but follow his instruction. Just don't go to the counter or pharmacy or read some advertisements and buy some medicine because your neighbor or your cousin has brought it. And with this note, doctor, once again, I thank you very much for all your efforts to come here and also give us some tips to manage our, I'm taking a little liberty, a non-veg diet, because sometimes I used to get always scared. Means Ayurvedic doctor means always he talks only about veg diet.
No.
So, but you have given us liberty, but I will call it a balanced liberty.
Absolutely.
With this note, doctor, thank you very much. So nice of you. God bless you. तुमका सगळ्यांची कार्य आवडली असतील. आम्ही हे मुद्दाम इंग्लिशन केला जे आमचे यंगस्टर्स त्यांच्याने हे मुद्दाम पोहोचिन. आय फील दॅट शुड बी शेअर्ड. युट्यूबर येतली त्यांनाही तुम्ही सगळ्यांनी स्पेअर करा आणि हातला जो इम्पॉर्टंट मेसेज तो फॉलो करा. दॅट्स हाऊ वी कॅन बिल्ड अ हेल्दी कम्युनिटी विथ दिस वर्ड. थँक यू डॉक्टर.
सो
नाईस.
थँक
यू. आज गोयात डिझेलच्या धुमराक लागून कितलेशेच प्रदूषण वाढला. हवेन वाढलेल्या कार्बनाक लागून लोकांक श्वास घेवपाक त्रास जाता. अरे डिस्टर्ब करू नाका रे रामसो. जसे व्हडल्या व्हडल्या शहरांनी प्रदूषणाचो लेवल वाढला तशी दुयेंसाय वाढल्या. अशीच परिस्थिती आमच्या गोंयानूय येतली काय असो सगळ्यांक भंय पडला.
अरे बस येता. अरे बस येतली जाल्यार गोंग 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 करून आवाज करतली. पेरे 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 करून होरून मारतली. कळ्ळें मरे
हे कितें रे आवाज जातो ना चमत्कार.
चमत्कार न्ही गोंय सरकार पोल्युशन फ्री इको फ्रेंडली इलेक्ट्रीक बसीस धांवतात गोंयच्या रस्त्यार.
कदंबा ट्रान्सपोर्ट कॉर्पोरेशनच्यो ई बसीस विथ फुल्ली एअर कंडिशन 40 सिटिंग कॅपेसिटी USB सॉकेट्स रिजनरेटिव्ह ब्रेकिंग सिस्टम आणि प्रवाशांच्या सुरक्षे खातीर एमर्जन्सी बटन.
कदंबा बसी आमकां जितल्यो फॅसिलिटीज दितात तितल्योच फॅसिलिटीज म्हाजी बस ह्या स्किमी अंतर्गत जवळ जवळ 25 प्रायव्हेट बसी आमकां दितात. म्हणजे स्टुडंट्सांक कन्सेशन, सिनियर सिटिझन्सांक कन्सेशन आणि कॅन्सर पेशंट्सांक फ्री ट्रॅव्हल. इतलेच न्ही प्रायव्हेट बस ओनराक सुद्धा ह्या स्किमींतल्यान खूप आदार मेळटा. आ करून कितें पळयता आतां उलय.
आतां कितें उलो भिवपाची सोड आतां उलोवपाची गरज ना.
शुद्ध श्वास आरोग्यदायी प्रवास आरोग्याची हमी गोय सरकार पडचो ना खंयच कमी.